Wow, dude, this thing is disgusting.
Well, there's so much rust. Maybe we should wipe it with a wet rag.
What the? I'm not gonna do that.
Why not?
Because it's a goddamn circuit breaker, Mac. We'll get electrocuted. Now, look, I'm just gonna use this screwdriver. I just got a rubber handle. That'll keep me grounded.
No, I'm pretty sure you have to be standing on rubber.
Well, the bottoms of my shoes are rubber.
Oh, no! You know what it is? You can't be standing on the ground at all. Maybe you should jump up into midair and do it.
Hmm?
Yeah, if you jump into the air and grab a live wire, you won't get electrocuted. But then if you land on the ground and you're still holding that wire, you'll be blown to bits. I saw it in Tango and Cash.
So I'm supposed to risk my life based on something that you saw in the movie Tango and Cash?
Kurt Russell did.
You know?
Dude, what are you doing? Where's your Mario costume?
No, I went with a sexier look.
Sexy? Bro, we agreed on funny over sexy this year, so we could disarm the ladies? What is that? What even is that?
I'm that character from Lord of the Rings, Viggo Mortensen.
Okay, that is not the character's name. That's the actor's name. And you're not even getting that right.
What is so hard to understand?
I believe that if I inseminated the right woman, our seed could potentially, through an X-Men-type genetic mutation, create a son capable of bending steel.
Mm-mm.
That's completely insane.
Do you understand genetic mutations at all?
We got another problem, all right? We're running out of glasses, and I can't run the dishwasher because it's too big of a power suck. It's going to kill the AC.
I got a fix. We got this stuff back when we were going to have the Memorial Day party, but then we had to cancel it because of the blizzard.
Oh! You brought the...
Yeah! That's working together, baby. Nice.
The Lord provideth again.
No, Mac. No. The Lord not provideth. Frank provideth. He's the one who bought the cups. Frank provideth.
The Lord provideth the snowstorm in May that allowed us to get the cups now. See, It's all a part of his divine plan, Dennis. And that's locked in, so we're good.
Okay, so all we have to do is nothing.
No, because we have free will, Dennis, which means that we have to take the necessary steps to make sure that that plan comes to fruition.
Which is predetermined.
Yes.
But it doesn't matter what we do if it's all predetermined. You see how your argument doesn't make any sense?
That's correct. But it doesn't have to make sense, because that's where the faith comes in. Right? I have faith that what I'm saying makes sense.
Okay, so even if it doesn't make sense, your faith makes it make sense.
Correct.
Got it. Okay, so there's no way to have a rational conversation with you.
No.
Do you or do you not believe that you could create a superhuman race of strong men through genetic mutation and evolution?
What difference does that make?
If you believe something that insane, then how could you be our tastemaker? How could we believe anything that you have to say? I'm gonna ask you one more time. Do you or do you not believe that you can create a superhuman race of strong men through genetic mutation and evolution?
No. That's ridiculous, Dee. What are you talking about?
Wait a minute. Mac. Why don't you believe that?
Huh?
Well, I'm just wondering, why don't you believe that you could pass down a gene that would eventually evolve into a race of supermen?
Why? Oh, well, that's a silly question. Because evolution doesn't exist, of course.
I'm sorry?
Oh, could you repeat that again for the room?
Because evolution is bullshit. It's not real.
God damn it, recess!
I swallowed some apple seeds today.
Did you make yourself throw up?
I tried, but I couldn't.
Smoke some cigarettes. The smoke will suffocate the bacteria in your stomach.
Oh, holy shit, this dentist must have gone insane after his dog died. I mean, look at this.
Charlie, I'm beginning to think that we may have stumbled onto one of the greatest discoveries of modern times. Follow me here. What if the key to Adolf Hitler's madness was the death of his dog?
What?
Okay, when he was a kid, he had this little sweet little puppy, and he was the happiest chap in all of Germany.
Right, oh, I love chocolate, I love my dog.
Yeah, but then his beloved pet was ripped from him, and he was like, that's it.
I'm totally gonna kill everybody, take over the world.
That is what happened.
Hey, dude, I just made a date with that girly rock star's people.
Bon Jovi?
Yeah, he owns the Philadelphia Soul, the arena football team. I just offered to buy it.
Awesome! All right, now I'm gonna pretend that I have terminal cancer and get him to do an acoustic set on my deathbed.
Why would you do that? You don't have to do that.
No, it's great, bro. Rock stars do the cancer kid thing all the time. Look, Frank!
No!
You got us into a room with Jovi's people, right? I'm gonna get us into a room with Jovi himself.
I'm sorry, that's a stupid idea, and I don't want you to do it.
Well, I already got a bald cap guy and everything.
You're just confusing everything.
There's nothing confusing about it, Frank. It's very, very simple.
Shut up! Shut your big mouth right now! I will put my foot down right now. You are not going in there with that cancer thing. I don't care what you say. So get it out of your head.
Okay, Jesus, dude. I won't do the cancer thing. Relax.
Ma'am, I am dying of very terminal cancer, and I would like to request a private bedside concert from Mr. Bon Jovi. Now, Sambora's presence is not necessary, but it would be nice if he was involved. Question, is this a laser pointer?
Yes.
Can I have it?
No.
Please don't listen to anything he says.
No, no.
I'll give you
Frank,
$60 million
Frank,
for the team.
I got it. We're talking about cancer. Nobody cares about arena football anymore. You're not negotiating shit. We're onto the cancer thing now, and that is the way that it's going to go from here.
Okay, I'm just going to throw this out there. I don't think you have cancer.
What? What are you talking about? No, that's chemo. That's chemotherapy right there.
And for the record, when you go through chemo, your beard hair falls out too.
Are you sure?
I
asked a lot of people. I asked my bald cap
to
guy.
Do the cancer thing.
Let me get this straight. You want to try and solicit a bribe?
Yes.
You want my union to back your roommate for South Philly District 37 comptroller?
Yes.
But not to win?
Correct.
Sounds illegal.
Oh, for God's sakes. Let me take you bitches to school for a second. In this country, in the real world, people make money. Somebody is going to make a ton of money off my roommate. I want
to make one thing perfectly clear. We are not a criminal organization.
Why are you talking to me like I'm a jackass? I am not a Oh. I see what you're doing. Okay. Nobody here is a criminal. No, sir.
I think we're speaking the same language. Are we?
Oh, yeah. We're being listened to. Bugged. The feds. I get it. I read. I see movies. I understand. Okay. I want you to contact me at Patty's. I'm gonna get the ball rolling. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's safe there. Okay, gentlemen. Sorry we couldn't work anything out, but I'm gonna go home and pay my taxes.
This guy's in Orlando for the week?
Yeah, man, come on, help me out here.
Oh, hold on a second, bro. This is the perfect opportunity. I'm gonna hang out in his office and pretend I'm the new guy.
I don't think that's gonna work, dude.
Have you seen the secret of my success?
They're gonna catch on to you.
Yeah, but before they do, I will come up with an idea that will save the company millions and they'll be forced to promote me.
Are you sure? How's that movie end, dude?
I can't remember. Oh, yeah, he bangs that old lady, and then they play that song from the 80s, De Bao Bao. What the hell is De Bao Bao?
De Bao Bao.
Ch-ch-ch-ch-ca. Oh, De Bao Bao. Oh, yeah. De Bao Bao. De Bao Bao. Beautiful. De Bao Bao. No, Max, you're still.
Hello, beautiful.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Who is this?
This is Mac. I'm the new guy.
What are you doing in my office?
So.
Huh?
Who are you and why are you in my office?
Who's this?
This is Johnson.
Oh. I thought you were in Orlando.
I am in Orlando. I'm trying to check my voicemail.
Oh. I can check it for you if you want.
Just look. What is your name, sir? Why don't you just give me your name? Your full name, sir.
Smokey loves me, dude. Hey, he's giving me one of those email addresses.
Email? Mark my words, nobody will ever use email. The internet is a fad for nerds.
Mobile phones.
Fads for yuppies. Mark my words, Charlie. Those things will never catch on. Charlie, in 20 years, everybody's gonna have a beeper. Mark my words.
Guys, mark my words. When we're finished with this place, you're not even gonna recognize it. I got a lot of things wrong.
Hey, can I talk to you for a second?
Yeah, hey. Hey, I came up with a really great idea, dude.
Yeah?
I'm gonna play both sides.
Why would you tell me that?
Should I not have?
Probably shouldn't, because if you're trying to keep a secret from me, well, now I know.
Should I tell them?
No, I don't think you should tell either side, because if you're trying to play both sides and they both know, you're not playing anybody.
What should I do now?
I don't give a shit. Charlie and I doctored a paternity test to make it look like Frank is Charlie's dad. But the tests were actually inconclusive. There was too much blood in the bucket to tell. The reason I'm telling you all this is because I'm playing both sides so that I always come out on top.
So, with this information, I'm going to leverage you guys into making me the head of security at the new Patty's Pub.
Okay. Couple things right off the bat there, pal. Number one, never tell one side that you're playing both sides.
Yeah.
And number two, if you are going to play both sides, don't give away the information before you get what you want.
Oh, shit. Right. Don't give away the information.
Yeah.
Well, all right. Well, if I am going to play both sides, what should I do?
You're still telling us that you're playing both sides? So why would we help you?
So I'm going to need $40 for, I'm going to need $40.
Oh, no, he didn't. We got a problem here, fellas?
Yeah,
that's a gat.
He's got a gun, so.
I got a gat.
Shoot the tires. What the hell is this?
That's the handle, just the handle.
I can see that. You're carrying around a gun handle?
Yeah, I found it in the trash. It's
oh
so cool,
oh, my God,
though.
Dude. That was so stupid. We could have gotten killed, man.
No. There's no bullets. You can't get killed because there's not... You can't get shot.
With their gun!
Oh, with their gun. Yeah, with their gun, we could have gotten killed.
Okay, so first things first. Hold the hockey stick.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good, because I was thinking I'd have a position sort of like this. Why would you do that? All of my instincts and my training tell me to use this as a weapon.
All of your instincts and your training are wrong.
We're actually here for good cause. We want to protect this school.
Oh.
Yeah, we want to be the armed security guards.
Yeah, I brought a piece. We're good.
Hey, no.
Calm yourself.
No, you got to put...
It's not currently loaded.
That's not the... Just put
it
away.
I hear you, buddy. He shouldn't have a gun in a school in the first place anyway.
No.
Guns just do not belong in schools.
No, they do not.
That is why I brought along... Saber.
Jesus Christ.
Which is just about the most ridiculous thing I've ever seen in my life, because how are you going to stop a gunman with that?
Bro,
he's going to get you from a distance.
If I come at you, I'll get to you faster. We have been arguing about this all day.
Because it's insanity.
Okay. Oh,
it's a
form of insanity. Maybe you can be the judge.
I don't want to... What?
Here we go. I'm going to holster my weapon. He'll holster his weapon. I'll do like a 1, 2, 3 count. You tell us who goes faster.
Please don't do this here.
It's the only way to tell, okay? And then we can protect your school, but we got to go one step at a time, all right?
Well, before he can draw his weapon. Hi!
How awesome is that?
Yeah, that's pretty awesome, but I feel like he would have shot you from a mile away.
No, he wouldn't, because you saw how I was zigzagging like this and making sounds? It was distracting.
Yeah, but did you ever see Indiana Jones where the guy does the whole sword thing and then he just shoots him dead?
Are you asking me if I've seen Indiana Jones? Are you seriously asking me? I've seen that. Well, that is my... You're not understanding.
You remember it?
Yes, but if I were to come at you, it's all about how I... Okay, in that circumstance, maybe you got there a little bit faster. But if I... Okay.
I got you again.
What if I zigzag like this?
It's so easy to get you.
That's not necessarily... I don't think that's...
And the place that we're going to is... Yellow? What is this? Who wrote this?
Me. Yeah.
What, were you trying to say Yellowstone, or what?
Just yellow.
Just yellow, just the color yellow.
I panicked, you know? You're shooting down all the other places I've been naming, so...
Okay, well, that's not
I
a goddamn place, idiot. So, we're gonna try this again. Next place I pick out, that's where we're gonna go.
Uh-huh.
Purple. What is happening?
That was me. Yeah, I did purple.
You did purple?
Yeah.
Two of you wrote colors?
So you thought a color.
I didn't understand the assignment either.
It was not clear.
I said write down a destination, and two people wrote down colors. I don't understand.
I like purple.
I like purple too, Frank. That's
what
I wrote
down. Well, maybe we can go there. That could be purple.
Go where? Purple? That's not a place.
You fellas strike me more as men of leisure.
Obviously.
Well, we are.
Yeah. You guys been to Florida?
Been there. Not physically.
If you want, I can set you up with one of their private villas.
Private villa. Whatever. That's pretty nice. Look at that.
Oh, it is nice.
Yeah. Did you know that the average rate for a hotel room 30 years ago was $19? Today, it's $237. That's a 1,300% increase. So it's not inconceivable to think that in another 30 years, a week at a hotel runs you $20,000.
That's not inconceivable. That's
crazy.
Very, very conceivable.
Really?
But not for you guys. You'll be locked in at $1,400 annually.
Wait, we would be?
Yeah. I'm not talking about taking a vacation, guys. I'm talking about owning a vacation. And look, if you're still not comfortable with the numbers, you just double down. You get 2 weeks, sell that second week, boom, you're vacationing for free.
Wait. Mac, I think this guy just bent himself over a barrel a little bit.
He did?
Yeah, for our pleasure. Follow me here. Okay, so if we buy a second week and we sell that, we're vacationing for free. What happens if we buy a third week and sell that?
We're getting paid to vacation. Oh, shit.
Guys, I've actually never thought of it like that. I'm not sure I can make that deal.
The deal's locked in.
I'm gonna write in three.
Write in 3 weeks.
Three here.
That's done.
Yeah, write in three. On
you got. You thought we were a bunch of suckers, but guess what? God. We're not. We just bought 3 weeks of a timeshare.
It's too streaky.
Where?
Everywhere. Fix it.
Well, I'm trying, Frank. I've never spray painted a chair before, okay? Why are you covering your mouth?
Because that lead paint is extremely toxic.
What? Is that why I'm feeling so dizzy?
Hey, all I'm hearing is excuses, and I still have a blotchy chair.
Wait a second. What am I saying? What am I doing here?
You're making my chair look like it was dipped in gold. Now get back to work.
Nobody is stupid enough to think that your chair was dipped in gold, Frank, okay? Why am I helping you?
Because I'm manipulating you. That's the way I get people to do things for me.
Really?
Yeah.
Shit, that's awesome. Mm. How did you do that?
If you make my chair look really nice, I will tell you.
Deal!
Talking through the issues may be the best way for you to address your mood swings and body issues.
Talking about it. No, that's good. That's good. So if we talk about it, then you think that I'll get most bigger from talking. Oh, that's really good. You know,
that's not what I
thank you. Meant. Thank you for this. Guys, I got us banter cards. Mac, you're gonna welcome the customer in, and then I'm gonna execute with a quip. Let's give it a shot. Hey, I'm Mac. Welcome to Patty's Pub. I would like to recommend to first-timers our signature blended drink, Caribbean Paradise. People say it's better than an orgasm. Guys, memorize these lines, okay? We need to seem like it's coming off the cuff.
Hi, can I get a drink?
Hey, I'm Mac. Welcome to Patty's Pub. I like to recommend to our first-timers our signature cocktail, Caribbean Paradise. Some people say it's better than busting a nut.
Excuse me?
Busting a nut. It's like, blowing your load.
Oh.
He said it was a funny joke.
Well, hold on.
Yeah, it's like coming all over you.
No.
It's light. It's playful.
Yeah, well, no, I think what my friend is trying to refer to is an orgasm, which is light and playful. But he overstepped himself and got a little bit too specific.
Sorry, we jizz in the drink, and that's what makes it light.
No, nobody's jizzing on anything.
Well, where do I jizz?
You don't jizz.
How can I orgasm if I don't jizz?
No, ma'am, I think...
Just tell me where I jizz so I can give this lady her drink.
Ma'am, what would you like to drink? And we won't jizz on anything.
Are you familiar with the beheading that took place here last week?
Are you a cop?
No, but I do work on the behalf of the accused. Why don't you tell us what you saw?
I didn't see either of those guys, okay?
There was more than one guy?
I said too much. I don't want any trouble, okay?
Well, then stop giving us trouble and tell us if there was another guy.
My lips are sealed, guys.
Then unseal them or I'll unseal them for you.
Hey. What the hell are you doing? You can't threaten this guy.
Threaten? I wasn't threatening him.
How do you not know what a threat sounds like?
Oh, you mean the lips thing?
Yes, the lips thing.
Charlie, he's got words in his lips. I needed to get them out.
I know the words are in his lips. I saw them in there. Just let me coax them out.
It should be coming up right here. Yeah, the house of McDonald is at this address here.
Wow. Yeah, nailed it. Cool, so your dad grew up in a McDonald's? Or
no, like... no, my dad didn't grow up in a McDonald's.
You sure? Because this is the house of McDonald. Hey, oh, you know what, dude? Maybe you are, like, from the McDonald family. Like, are you the Ronald McDonald? Like, is the hamburger clown named after you?
I can't tell if you're making fun of me right now.
We'll clear all this stuff off, we'll start to paint, all right? And by the time you guys coming back, I promise the boat will be looking better.
I can't tell. Is he patronizing me again? I can't even tell
you.
No. Show me, Cal!
Nope, that's me. I say that word. I say the show me part, and you just give me the answer. Okay, Ronald?
Right, I'm sorry. Show me, Cal!
Don't say show me. Don't say it. Just say the answer.
Show me is the part I say.
Here's the one thing. There's only one thing in the whole world at this moment you shouldn't say. Show me. So just give me the answer, and then I'll say, you know what? Go ahead and do it. Just go ahead and do it then.
Do what?
Mother of...
Start thinking of a steal, because if we get this one, we win the game. All right. So, what's the question?
Things people are afraid of.
That's still the question?
Yes. How do you not know how the game works by now?
Okay, I'm afraid of game show rules.
We made every single one of our Patty's dollars back,
You're
buddy.
You're damn right. Thus creating the self-sustaining economy we've been looking for.
That's right.
How much fresh cash did we make?
Fresh cash?
Yes.
Well, zero. Zero if you're talking about U.S. currency. People didn't really seem interested in spending any of that.
That's okay. So when they run out of the booze, they'll come back in and they'll have to buy more Patty's dollars.
Right.
Keeping it moving.
That is assuming, of course, that they will come back here and drink.
They will.
They will, because we'll redistribute these to the shanties, thus ensuring them coming back in, keeping the money moving.
Well, no, but if we just redistribute these, then people will continue to drink for free.
Okay.
How does this work, Mac?
The money keeps moving in a circle.
But we don't have any money. All we have is this. How does this work,
dude? I don't know.
Well, I could put the trash into a landfill where it's going to stay for millions of years. Or I could burn it up, get a nice smoky smell in here, and let that smoke go into the sky where it turns into stars.
That doesn't sound right, but I don't know enough about stars to dispute it.
No, it might be good to set up some boundaries.
Boundaries? Sounds like it's coming right out of Stalin's mouth.
Stalin's mouth? Yes. That is not what we're talking about.
Saying,
we're
just saying who Stalin is.
He doesn't even...
Who the hell is Stalin? Listen, man, just keep them under control.
You're the most misinformed person that I've ever met. You don't even know what's going on in Israel.
Okay, that's right. You don't know what's going on in Israel. Maybe you shouldn't be speaking
to the subject. Are you guys serious?
Yes. Maybe you should leave it to me.
I'm sorry. Do you know what's happening in Israel?
Of course, bro. I read the newspaper.
Oh, okay. Well, you know what? Why don't you crack an egg analogy all over me?
Okay.
Can I start?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, okay. There's a war on terror, Charlie. Mm-hmm. Have you ever seen CNN?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
George Bush right now.
Yeah. Well, start from the beginning. Saddam Hussein has the oil.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
Charlie, we have decided to help the people of Israel
to give our oil back to us by defeating Saddam Hussein.
My head is like swelling with knowledge.
It's freedom, Charlie.
Like wonderful knowledge.
No, you're being sarcastic when we're talking about our... You can't hide from it forever.
You're an idiot.
You're an idiot.